What's up guys, and the Galaxy Note 20's time has arrived. Rossian has now come out to review the Note 20 after the Mega Galaxy Fold 2 leaks. Yes, he's the guy behind the Galaxy Fold 2 leaks, and now he once again back here to reveal the Note 20. Now along with that, we also have some new and exciting information on partnership that we want Samsung with AMD. First up, here we have the Galaxy Note 20 family and of course Note 20 and Note 20 Plus models only. The Samsung Galaxy Note 20 Ultra is indeed not gonna happen. We have talked about it before, and yes, it is now further confirmed by Rossian. So he further revealed that display on the Galaxy Note 20 will be 6.4 inches, a little bit bigger than 6.3 inch on the Note 10. There is also going to be a slight increase in resolution. So you're looking at 2345 by 1084 pixel resolution with 404 ppi 120Hz refresh rate with LTPO variable refresh rate support. I don't know how well Samsung optimized their variable refresh rate, but considering the fact that they are working on this before the release of the Galaxy S20 Ultra, so it might be better, definitely better than Google Pixel 4. Now as for the Galaxy Note 20 Plus, so we also have an increase in display size as well as in resolution. So the display is now 6.87 compared to the 6.8 inch on the Note 10 Plus, and here we also have an increase in resolution coming at 3096 by 1444 and 497 ppi. This is the highest resolution display on Samsung smartphone. And here we also have a 120Hz refresh rate with LTPO, so lower power consumption with 120Hz because of the variable refresh rate. Hopefully it will be better, far better than what Google implement with their Pixel 4. And then again, there is no Ultra model of the Note 20, but Rossian revealed that Galaxy Fold 2 will be your Ultra. I've already made a video on the Galaxy Fold 2, so you'd be better watch that video, and also possible price of that phone also got leaked. So of course, eagerly waiting for the price of the Note 20 from one and only Rossian. Also, as we all know now, that Exynos 1000 is indeed a chip that will be housing the AMD's GPU. We've already talked about that the 5nm Exynos 1000 chip based on latest ARM architecture cores will rock an AMD's RDNA graphics architecture for the first time in history. And now the big news is that Samsung and AMD's chip could power the next console, gaming console, Nintendo Switch. According to news, Nvidia doesn't have the ARM-based CPU solution which Nintendo wants for its next console, so they are asking from AMD to help since they have experience in producing ARM-based solution, and based on how closely they are working with Samsung, it is expected that next Nintendo console might be powered by the new Exynos 1000 chipset. This is indeed a game changing for both Nintendo and Samsung. Imagine the same chip inside your Galaxy S21 powering your console, a gaming console that alone speaks for its performance. We already have an early glimpse of AMD's GPU and Exynos via benchmark, and it beats Adreno 650 about 15% margin. So imagine the final deal where they get with the Galaxy S21. So I'm really excited to see what this partnership will bring to the table. And it's not the only upgrade Samsung's making with the Galaxy S21. Samsung is trying to seriously pushing the limits next year with S21 family. I already have a full playlist, so do check that out if you want to, and subscribe to the channel for daily tech videos, and yeah, I'll see you in the next one.